Hello everyone, welcome to Nirja Education. This is class 10th science lesson number 2, acids, bases and salt. Before seeing this video, go through my previous videos, then only you will get the continuity. At the same time, please subscribe our channel Nirja Education and don't forget to press the bell icon. In this session, we are going to discuss about the chemical properties of acids. We are going to discuss about the third chemical property of an acid, that is called a neutralization reaction. What is mean by neutralization reaction? That is very, very important question. They will ask for one or two more questions. So, neutralization reaction is nothing but when the acid react with base, it produce salt and water. As we all know that the topic name is acid, base and salt. The salt is produced in the form combination of acid as well as base. So this process is called a neutralization. In the previous reaction also, we get the salt as a byproduct. Even the metal react with acid to produce salt. Even the metal bicarbonate or hydrogen carbonate react with acid to produce salt. But here acid and base, this acid and base react to produce salt. That's why this reaction is called a neutralization. Right, so here I gave the example, hydrochloric acid react with the sodium hydroxide, it produce NaCl plus water. There are the two byproduct, salt plus water, W for water. The next one is HCl react with MgOH twice, it produce MgCl2 plus water. Next one is hydrochloric acid react with KOH, that is produce KCl plus H2O, potassium chloride. Next, KCl plus react with calcium hydroxide, that is a lime water, it produce calcium chloride, CaCl2 plus water. These all are the examples of neutralization reaction. I hope you have understood the neutralization reaction. What is neutralization reaction means? When the acid react with base, it produce salt and water. That reaction is called a neutralization reaction. The reaction of metallic oxide, this is the last reaction of acid. So here the metallic oxide react with acid to produce salt and water. Here the same byproduct like neutralization, but here acid is there. What about base? Here the metallic base is the having the character of basic. So the metallic oxide having the character of basic character. So that metallic oxide react with acid. So here the basic character react with acid to produce salt and water. Here I am taking the example copper oxide. Copper oxide react with the hydrochloric acid, it produce copper chloride. Copper chloride, it is a bluish color, bluish green color solution will be changed. The colorless solution is changed into bluish green color solution, that is called a copper chloride. Same like that, if you take magnesium oxide react with the hydrochloric acid, it produce magnesium chloride and water. These are the examples of the metallic oxide react with acid. Here, as we all know that metallic oxides are basic in nature because they give salt and water on reacting with acid. But some of the metallic oxides are react with both acid as well as base. Those oxides are called amphoteric oxide. This is very, very important. Take a note of it. What is amphoteric oxide? Give two examples. This is the important question. Amphoteric oxides are nothing but the oxides which react with acid as well as base. Here the metallic oxides are react with only acid, but some of the metallic oxide react acid as well as base. Those oxides are called amphoteric oxides. Example, amphoteric acid, once again I repeat, some of the metallic oxide react with both acid as well as base. Those oxides are called amphoteric oxides. Example, zinc oxide ZnO and aluminium oxide Al2O3. These two are examples of amphoteric oxides. Here the zinc oxide react with acid HCl, it produce zinc chloride ZnCl2 plus H2O. Clear? Same like that, when zinc oxide react with the sodium hydroxide, it produce Na2ZnO2 will produce. This is called a sodium zinc oxide. It is called a sodium zinc oxide plus water will be produced. This is the example. Here you see this zinc oxide react with acid also as well as base also. So that it is called amphoteric oxide. Once again I repeat, zinc react with the hydrochloric acid, it produce zinc chloride and as well as water, same like that zinc oxide. Zinc oxide react with the sodium hydroxide, it produce sodium zinc oxide plus water. Same like that aluminium oxide react with hydrochloric acid, it produce aluminium chloride, AlCl3, aluminium chloride plus water. You have to balance the equation. Al2O3 react with 6HCl, it produce 2AlCl3, aluminium chloride plus water. Same like that, aluminium oxide react with sodium hydroxide, it produce sodium aluminium oxide. Sodium aluminium oxide. When the aluminium oxide react with sodium hydroxide, it produce sodium aluminium oxide plus water. Right? So, these are the examples of amphoteric oxide. I hope you have understood the chemical properties of acid. Now I am writing the generalized reaction heading, you will be able to understand. This is the quick recap of the reactions of acid. This is the chemical property. There are the 5 chemical properties are there. The first, acid react with metal, it produces salt and hydrogen gas. We confirm hydrogen gas with the pop test. Second one is acid react with metal carbonate, it produce salt, carbon dioxide and water. Then this carbon dioxide confirmation we can do by lime water test. Then acid react with metal hydrogen carbonate or metal bicarbonate, it produce salt, carbon dioxide and water. These two reaction byproducts are same. Then acid react with base, it produce salt and water. This reaction is called a neutralization reaction. The last reaction is acid react with metal oxide, it produce salt and water. Here the metal oxide is act as a basic character, so that it react, it produce salt as well as water. In this category we discuss about the amphoteric oxide. I hope you have understood the chemical properties of acid. Next video we will discuss the chemical properties of base. Thank you. Have a nice day.